Do you enjoy these cool muzzle flashes from guns in action movies? You don't need a real gun to have them in your film. They are quite easy to do in post-production, and I will show you how to realize it with free tools. First, you need some footage to work with. Just film somebody faking the recoil of a shot. If you don't want to create your own special effects footage, you can find free stuff online. You will prefer the ones which have transparent background to limit your work. Watch the ending credits to see where I found time. Finally, you need some gun sound. I use Openshot as video editing software and import these files to a new project. The filmed scene is dragged onto the second top track. Find a recoil timestamp and use the left and right arrow keys of your keyboard to find the frame just before it. Drag the visual effect to exact this frame on a track above the footage. As it is likely not made to fit your scene perfectly, adjust size and position. The visuals only for themselves are a bit boring, so add a track on which you can drag the sound. Copy the timestamp of the muzzle flash footage to synchronize your audio sample. Find the exact time where your sound starts and adjust the length accordingly. That's already much cooler. In reality, the gunfire will light its environment. There would be light on the background, the arms and the face. So to make it look more realistic, you need to create a light map. Find the frame of the flash and make a copy of the still by pressing Ctrl+Shift+D. You will find the file in the project folder. Just open it in an image editing software like GIMP. Open the Layers window and add a new layer which will contain your light map for the background. Change the foreground color to something which is similar to your muzzle flash effect. Select the gradient tool, set the radiant shape to circular, and select a foreground to transparent gradient. This might not exist by default, so you may have to create it by yourself. This is part of other tutorials. Let the gradient start at the gun muzzle and draw it to a repetitive point which resembles your light radius. I chose the shoulder. Now select the rubber tool and remove everything which is not lit background. I like to reduce the layer's opacity to be able to see which parts need to be removed. Set the final opacity of this layer depending on how far away your background is. The farther, the lower. You will need a second light map for things in the foreground. Put a virtual wall through a person to imagine which parts are lit and which not. Add the new layer. and create the gradient as for the background. Make the existing layer invisible, such that it doesn't irritate you. Now remove everything which is not lit. In this case, the background, the upper side of the base cap, and the backside of the arms. Make the background layer visible again and erase the foreground where both layers still overlap. Set the foreground layer's opacity to 100% and make the image layer invisible such that you only see the light maps. Finally, save your work in an image format which supports transparency. Back in Openshot, import the image to your project. Drag it to a track above your footage and below the effect. Copy the timestamp of your effect and paste this value to your lightmap properties. Set the length depending on your final frame rate. Usually the duration of a single frame is sufficient, but I like to make it a bit longer but let it fade in and out quickly when targeting high frame rates or slow motion. Reduce the alpha value until you like the flash's intensity. And don't forget to adjust the end settings as well. I've prepared some demo footage. The drone sequences were done by Matthias Tietlund. We also made a tutorial on how to realize such results in Adobe Premiere Pro. Check out his video to learn about the workflow in this program and to see an alternative ending. He also has some more pretty cool content on his channel. It was one of those cloudy days and I was on guard duty. So I did what a man has to do.
Stop! Who are you? Don't move!